just saying fancy decorated surfboard. First of all, I never owned a surfboard, so that's a bit of a problem. If you're referring to the surfboard that was in the, it was just a white plain surfboard that was in the place where I did laundry in Israel once. That's Israel's. I don't know. So you never see me touching it, nothing. Second of all, that's not very fancy. No, the thing with that statement, it doesn't make much sense. I don't know. I think you're saying I'm a beginner, right? You obviously are never good at anything. So you're saying that I'm a beginner surfer or something? Okay, well, in that case, I'm going to have a high buoyancy board. High buoyancy board, about 8 foot long, and it's going to have, it's going to be a soft board, it's going to be probably foam, and most likely brand-wise WaveStorm, because that's what beginners ride. As far as fancy boards, fashionable, it's not likely, because a lot of those fancier boards are made that way for people that really know what they're doing. It's like wearing a fancy wetsuit or something. You're likely not going to do that unless you are at the size. Now, it actually makes more sense of a fancy wetsuit than it does a fancy board, because those fancy boards, there tend to be functioning at a more advanced level. Since you're saying I'm not advanced, it's not likely that I'd have one of those highly decorated boards, because I wouldn't be able to fucking stay even on the board. Right? So what most realistically you're looking at for a new lead is a foam. Now, foam boards, or the boards that I'm saying, are probably going to be between $200 and $300. They're not that expensive. That's what a beginner board costs. So you're not making much sense.